I am Raghavendra Rao. I am here to talk about Hardy-Weinberg equation. This can be Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, Hardy-Weinberg principle. This equation is put forwarded by two individuals. One is Hardy is a British mathematician and Weinberg is a German physician. So these people together put forward Hardy-Weinberg equation in 1907 and 8. When we talk about what does this Hardy-Weinberg equation tells us? Basically, it states that allele and genotype frequencies in a population will remain constant from generation to generation in the absence of other evolutionary influences, and they have given equation in the form of p square plus 2pq plus q square is equal to 1. Here, the evolutionary influences or evolutionary forces are, they are in general considered as 1. Genetic drift, 2. Natural selection, 3. Mutation, 4. Gene flow, 5. Mate choice. So these are the 5 set of evolutionary forces which has the ability to disturb the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. In absence of these 5 influences, definitely alleles and genotypes frequencies in a population remain always constant from generation to generation. Before we work with these equation, the problems which we solve using this Hardy-Weinberg equation, we need to know some of the tips regarding population genetics. So we will discuss first. Here you are able to see two individuals with two different types of hair color. One is having non-red hair, the other one is red hair. So which we are able to see with the naked eye. Physically, when we are able to distinguish characters or traits, basically we consider it as phenotype. Phenotype is nothing but it is a physical manifestation of the genes. We are generally considered as phenotype. Phenotypes are in general regulated by genes. We all know that the gene is nothing but it's a fragment of DNA which has precise information code for a trait. Here, genes are also having different types. Here, you are able to see the non-red hair color is coded by a different set of genes and the red color hair is coded by different color of genes. Means the different types of genes, which are in general, we consider it as alleles in the case of hair color. Allele is also considered as the alternative form of a gene. Now, the alleles which codes for non-red hair is big R. The alleles which code for red hair are little r. This is how normally we can define what is a phenotype, which is a purely physical manifestation of a gene. Now here, if you look into the two individuals, when we talk about a big R and a little r, so what would be the phenotype which is consists of big R and small r? Either it is of a non-red hair or it is of red hair. When we talk about, basically it gives a phenotype which is of non-red hair, because we all know that the non-red hair is dominant over red hair, and non-red hair alleles are capital R, capital R, or capital R, small r. In the sense, in these two combinations of alleles, it gives a phenotype called non-red hair. Basically, the red hair individuals are seen only when their genes are carrying alleles like little r. Now, we are able to see the phenotype of big R and little r is of non-red hair. This is the combination. When we talk about genotype, the big R and little r, here they stands the genotypic combinations of gene or allele, we consider it as genotype. The genotype can be defined as the genotypic arrangement of genes, we generally considered as genotype. Now, for a better understanding, I'm asking you some questions to understand your knowledge on phenotype and genotype. First of all, Huntington's disease, whether it is a phenotype or a genotype? Yes, it's a phenotype. Now we will see second one. PTC taste. So it's a chemical, the individual will feel, recognize the taste of this chemical. It, whether it is a phenotype or a genotype. Yes, this is also phenotype. Now we will move to the third one. Carrier of cystic fibrosis. Whether it is a phenotype or a genotype. Yes, it comes under genotype because this is the genetic makeup of the genes. We consider the individuals as a carrier or not based on the genotype. So that's why carrier of cystic fibrosis will always is considered as a genotype. Now when we talk about what is the role in the phenotype, means what is the role of alleles in the phenotype, basically as we have seen, the non-red hair is in general controlled by different combinations of alleles when it is compared to the red hair. When we talk about, first of all, if both the alleles are big R, generally they represent the phenotype of non-red hair, and that condition is called as homozygous conditions because they represent similar type of alleles, that is big R and big R. So big R and big R alleles represent the phenotype of non-red hair. Now when we talk about the phenotype of red hair individuals, they also carry similar alleles which are in general considered as little r. These are also homozygous condition. These together will produce a phenotypic effect in the individual hair, that is red hair. Along with this, one big R, one little r also will bring you another phenotypic combination that is in general considered to be also big R and small r, and the phenotype of this gene combination is nothing but it is a non-red hair which we see. So means you are able to see the non-red hair in the individual is in general controlled by big R as well as big R, little r. These two genotypes will result in a single phenotype, that is non-red hair. If an individual should have a red hair, basically it should have both little r, which results in a red hair phenotype individual. Now when we talk about a group of population phenotype, here you are able to see red is a recessive is phenotype and non-red hair is a dominant phenotype. Here you are able to see 10 individuals of population where they are having 5 are of red individuals and 5 are of non-red hair individuals in a population. Now when we talk about the frequency of these genotypes, we see we will calculate the frequencies of genotypes of that particular gene by the total number of genes present in the population. Now when we talk about phenotypes here, let us talk about the genotypes of these individuals in the population. Here you are able to see all the red hair individuals are having similar type of alleles, that is little r, where the phenotype of red individuals can only possible if they have recessive form of allele, that is little r. But when we look into the non-red hair individuals genotype, you will be having two types of combinations, that one individual is having a combination of big R and small r, which is also results in a phenotype called non-red individuals, because the big R is dominant over small r, which has resulted in the phenotype of non-red individuals. When we talk about the second category of allele combination in the non-red hair, is one is big R and big R. So this is a homozygous condition where both the alleles are big R and big R, which is also results in a phenotype called non-red hair individuals. So here the individuals which are having red hair, they carry little r, and the individuals which are of non-red hair, either they carry alleles combination of capital R or big R, small r. This is about the genotypes of the individuals which are present in the population. Now, if we pool all these genes together in a population, we generally consider that as gene pool. Gene pool can be defined as sum of the total genes present in a population is considered as gene pool. Here we have different alleles are present in the gene pool. There are yellow colored alleles which are stands for big R, and the red colored alleles which are stands for little r. Means when we talk about the number of big R's and number of little r's in the gene pool, we can stack them separately. Here the number of big R or non-red hair alleles are basically considered to be a total of 6 number are there, and if you consider the alleles which are dealing with the red color or recessive alleles, which are considered to be 14 number. Means when we talk about the total number of genes in the population, it is in general considered to be the 20. Now, to find out the frequency of dominant alleles and the frequency of recessive alleles, we can find out with the formulas. Here in the Hardy-Weinberg equation, P always stands for the frequency of dominant alleles, and the Q always stands for the frequency of recessive alleles. To know the frequency of dominant alleles, it is always that P is equal to the total number of dominant alleles, number is 6. So that's why 6 by total number of alleles, that is 20, which is giving about 0.3. Similarly, the frequency of Q is equal to the total number of recessive alleles in the population are 14. So total number of alleles 20, means Q is equal to 14 by 20, it comes 0.7 is the frequency of recessive allele in the population. So now you are able to see P value and Q value. There is a formula which is in general consider that P plus Q is equal to always 1. If you P represent 0.3 plus if you represent Q value, that is 0.7, this is always equals to 1. So that is always there, algebraic equation, P plus Q is equal to always 1. If you are able to find one of the allelic frequency, either P or Q, you are able to find the other value of either P or Q in this equation. Now, when we look into the Hardy-Weinberg equation, P square plus 2PQ plus Q square is equal to 1, it can be considered the P square always deals with the homozygous dominant alleles or genes. And Q square is always deals with the homozygous recessive alleles, and the 2PQ deals with the heterozygous genes or alleles which are present in the population. So the equation totally represents P square as homozygous dominant genes, Q square as homozygous recessive genes, and 2PQ as heterozygous genes in the population. Now, with this, if you are able to find out either the Q square or the P square, the rest of the values you can substitute by using this. Means you can very easily solve the Hardy-Weinberg law problems based on the equation when you are able to find P or Q values. Now, the genotypes for P square are big R, and the genotypes for 2PQ are big R, little r, and the genotypes for Q square are little r, little r. Now we will look into a problem by using the Hardy-Weinberg equation. So here it is saying that 2% of the humans on the planet have red hair. What percentage of individuals are heterozygous for this trait? Means you all know that the phenotype which is given here is red hair, and the individuals of red hair humans in the world population is 2%. So 2% of the individuals can be represented as 2 by 100, and you need to convert this into decimal form, that is 0.02. Always you have to convert the value which is given in the problem into decimal form, then only you can substitute the values in the Hardy-Weinberg equation. Now you have 0.02 individuals are having red hairs, and you also know that the red hair in the individual is mainly because of recessive. So red hair is a recessive trait. So because of that, it is very clear that the red hair phenotypes are possible only when both the recessive alleles are present. It stands that little r, little r. So the little r, little r stands Q square in the equation. If you say Q square is equal to 0.02, now you need to find out Q value. To get the Q value, you make it root of these two, that it gives you Q value as 0.14. Either you can convert this into percentage, 14% of the individuals in the world population are having red hair. Now, you always have an algebraical formula that P plus Q is equal to always 1. Now you have Q value, that P plus 0.14 is equal to 1. To find out P value, P is equal to 1 minus 0.14, which gives you a value of 0.86. This is the P value. Now you have P value, now you have Q value. Now if you add P and Q value, it always equal to 1. Now you represent these values in the Hardy-Weinberg equation. Now, what they have asked, they have given this value of red hair individual, and they are asking the heterozygous condition individuals, what percent of the humans will have heterozygous for this trait. Means in the equation I have already told previously, p square plus 2pq plus q square is equal to 1. Now you have q value, now you have p value, but p square represent the homozygous dominant and q square represent the homozygous recessive. Now they are asking here the percentage of humans with heterozygous condition. 2pq gives you the percentage of heterozygous individual when you substitute p value and q value here. Here we are substituting 2 into 0.14 into 0.86. This is the substitution your values in the p and q to find out the percentage of heterozygous individual. If you calculate, it comes around nearly 0.24. It means 24% of the population on this planet are having heterozygous condition for this trait, that is non-red hair individuals with heterozygous condition are represented 24%. In this way, we can solve the problems which are based on Hardy-Weinberg equation. Now, I'm giving you one more problem. Let us work out and find out the answer for this. 12% of the people in India have red hair. What percent of population is homozygous for non-red hair? Here they are asking, means when we see, they gave 12% of the individuals are having red hairs, means here they have given q square individuals, that is 12%, that is 12 by 100, it is nearly giving 0.12. similarly, they are asking value of q square percentage. What is the percentage of q square? So by substituting all the values as we have done in the previous experiment, you can extend this problem and solve this problem and come with the answer.